I've seen a lot of chatter online lately about one-ton swaps. A lot of people talking about the pros and cons of a junkyard swap versus a brand new custom axle, and I've seen so much misinformation and people making just wild exaggerations in order to, you know, fit their narrative or whatever. And so today what I'm going to do is I'm going to distill this talking point, this conversation down to its basic elements. I'm going to withhold my judgment, I'm going to withhold my opinion until the very end. Believe it or not, right now I am swapping out my Junkyard Dana 60 front axle and replacing it with a custom front axle from Fusion 4x4. I've gained a bunch of first-hand knowledge about the pros and cons of both swaps, and I'm actually really surprised at how close the price point is between these two options. Today we're not going to compare Dana 60s like the one that I'm installing. The one I'm installing is from a 2004 Ford Super Duty, and they really only use those for 2 years. Technically, you could find an 01 or an 02 that had this same axle, but the vast majority of them were Dana 50s. So realistically, we're only talking about a 2 year range of Dana 60. I wanna make this video to where we can paint with as broad a brush as possible. So hoping that you, the person who's watching right now, this information could apply to you because we're gonna use a much more popular axle in our comparison. So we're gonna use the 05 and up Super Duty axle. These were used for a lot bigger year range. So there's way more of them out there. And these are the hottest Dana 60 axle right now. By far, everybody wants a set of these. So if we've got a junkyard Dana 60, I figure about $1,000 is a pretty reasonable price based on the prices that I've seen over the last year plus. The cost of these axles has gone through the roof. They used to be really affordable, but everyone's doing them and it makes it harder to find them. And I will see 05 and up Super Duty axles go on Facebook Marketplace for $1,500 and it'll go within 30 minutes, they'll be gone. Because people are buying them up at prices much higher than $1,000. But I think $1,000 is pretty reasonable to be able to find. I think that that's a realistic expectation. And maybe somewhere in Kentucky, these are way cheaper. But up here in the Pacific Northwest, this is about the going rate. So then we've got, and I should mention, we're locked in at a 72-inch wheel mount surface to wheel mount surface measurement because there's not like flexibility or year ranges to choose from or anything. This is just what you get. It's not a custom axle. It's something that was built for another truck that you're gonna try to graft into your truck. So we add an ARB locker. ARB is probably the most popular locker out there, which is why I chose them. This price for most of this stuff is from East Coast Gear Supply. And the reason that I chose East Coast Gear Supply is because they are a really popular, really big company that a lot of people use. Again, trying to paint with a broad brush here. So we've got, this is the cost from them for the ARB. We've got $250 for a ring and pinion install kit from East Coast Gear Supply. $356.39 for 538 gears, $1,300 from Chromoly Shafts, all of this from East Coast Gear Supply, and then a Dana 60 diff cover from wherever you choose. The lowest price I've seen is about $110, and the highest price I've seen is like $250. So I figure $150 is a nice, just kind of medium like price point for a Dana 60 diff cover. The TJ bracket kit is $399, and that is pretty relative to no matter what company you use. You might be able to find it for like $50 higher, $50 lower, but $399 is pretty fair. And I chose TJ because the TJ bracket kit can be used in so many different vehicles. And again, trying to paint with a broad brush. So XJ owners, LJ owners, TJ owners, MJ owners, and I believe WJ owners, and maybe ZJ, I don't know. But I know that at least 5 different vehicles can use this TJ bracket kit, and everyone is swapping one tons into those Jeeps I just mentioned right now. So it's broad brush. Total would be $4,581.39. So $4,500, you've got a very solid foundation to build on. And I mean, this is a great set of parts with big joints. I mean, 35 spline shafts. This is a really good solid combo. The Fusion 60, and I just picked Fusion because this is the company that I'm working with right now for my one ton swap to fix what I messed up. I chose the wrong axle for my swap, and we'll get to that in a minute. So we've got the Fusion 60, which is an 05 and up Super Duty. If you go to the Fusion 4x4 website, you can click 05 and up Super Duty, and it's gonna fit all these exact same parts. It's the same parts. The only exception is because it's a custom axle, you're not locked in at 72 inches wheel mount surface to wheel mount surface, you can just tell them whatever size you want. So if you wanna go wider and you wanna go crazy,
You can. If you want to go narrower, you can. So if you have a CJ or a TJ and you drive it on the street, you want to only have like a 62 inch wheel mount surface to wheel mount surface, you can do that and you can be 10 inches narrower than these Super Duties. Or you can go crazy and go like really wide. Like I said, we've got ARB install kit, 538 gears, all the same stuff. Custom built chromoly shafts. So this is just to match whatever the axle width is that you chose. Then we've got a diff cover. Because it's a custom center section, they send you that custom cover to match. And then a TJ bracket kit, and we're at $47.45. So we're only talking about like a $200 difference in price between the two. So I think that this, whenever you actually break this down to an apples to apples comparison, it's very interesting at what the total cost ends up being.
Now, I've already done a video where I explain all the different reasons that this Junkyard Dana 60 is not gonna work like I thought it would for this Land Rover Discovery. But in short, the biggest reason is the pinion offset. The pinion is stuffed so far to the passenger side that even with a high angle drive shaft with high angle joints, I don't have hardly any down travel on the passenger side before it starts to bind up the drive shaft. But knowing what I know now and comparing the cost of these two different avenues, it's very apparent that I should have just got a custom axle made from the jump. The extra $200 in cost gets you a custom width, a custom pinion offset, a custom caster angle, a high clearance center section, because you can't get an aftermarket high clearance center section from a junkyard axle. Comes with a drain plug, it's guaranteed to be unbent, it comes with a warranty, and you don't have to cut off all those old brackets or clean all the rust out of the old housing. That extra $200 actually buys you a lot of options and value, and once again, knowing what I know now, I think it's very clear what decision I should have made from the beginning.
I want to end this video by trying to come to a middle ground with those of you that are just like popping your knuckles and getting ready to light me up on the keyboard. So I think that if you look at this as a truly apples to apples comparison, everything that I'm saying is very rational and reasonable. And I think that a lot of us would agree that if you just look at it on paper, we live in a time now where it makes a lot of sense to start transitioning to new parts and pieces instead of reusing junkyard stuff. Because 10 years ago, these axles, a brand new axle cost way more money. And a used axle was way less money. But now we're at this point where things are starting to meet in the middle, and you're gonna start seeing a lot more people like me use brand new parts and pieces because of the fact that it's just so much more reasonable for a lot of us. Now, also, there's a bunch of people who are gonna say, you could save more money than that on a junkyard axle by reusing, you know, A, B, or C. And yes, you could reuse seals or ball joints or whatever. You could reuse, to save money, you could reuse your stock shafts. But the fact is, you're no longer giving this an apples to apples comparison because you're comparing an inferior product. So you have something that's not as strong and trying to compare it against something that is like ultimate strength, you know? So I think that if you're doing this as a true apples to apples comparison, everything you see here makes sense. Not to mention the fact, I want to go on a little tangent about OEM axle shafts. I personally have broken a number of OEM axle shafts. I'm surrounded by people that break OEM axle shafts all the time. My friend Andy, 2 weeks ago, he just broke an OEM Dana 60 axle shaft. If you watch us on Trail to SEMA, Ben broke an 05 Super Duty axle shaft that was stock, and he just had that 3.8 van motor in his JK and 40s. And then Chris Miller broke a 04 Dana 60 axle shaft on the same trail, OEM, and he was on 40s, all in the same size tire as me, but I had a chromoly set of axle shafts in a Dana 44. So material type makes a really big difference in strength. So all that is just to say that whenever you watch a video like this, try to have as open-minded as possible, just take in the data and make the best decision that's gonna work for your build. I'm still gonna be using junkyard axles in the future, but up until now, all you've seen is junkyard axles, and in the future, you're gonna see a healthy mix because we're living in a time where it makes sense to start to go over and just get a custom axle that is made for your vehicle instead of grafting something off of an F-350 and hoping it'll fit on your Toyota or whatever the situation may be. So, tangent over, video over. Thank you so much for watching. If you did like it, give it a thumbs up. Go out, do your research. Buy stuff that makes sense for you. Just think about all of these. Take all this stuff into consideration as you move forward. If you want to help support the channel, you can go to thedirtlifestyle.com. T-shirts, hats, neck gaiters, all that stuff. Actually, we've got new T-shirts. My wife and this web developer are doing a great job on our new website, so check that out. We also have a link to our Patreon account there. And if you want to follow me on social media, I'm at dirtlifestylenate. We'll see you next time.